Once upon a time,
I wish
in a far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
lived a fair maiden,
more than life,
a sad young lad,
more than you,
I wish,
and a childless baker.
More than life,
I wish,
with his wife,
more than anything,
more than the moon,
I wish, the king is giving a festival,
more than life,
I wish to go to the festival,
more than riches,
and
I wish my cow would give us some milk,
more than anything,
I wish we had a choice,
I want a choice, I wish to go to the festival,
I wish we might have a child,
I wish. You wish to go to the festival?
The poor girl's mother had died.
You, Cinderella, the festival?
We wish to go to the festival, the festival, the king's festival.
And her father had taken for his new wife
the festival,
a woman with two daughters of her own.
Look at your nails.
Look at your dress.
People would laugh at you.
Nevertheless,
she still wants to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother?
I wish.
Well, she was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. You foolish child! What in heaven's name are you doing with a cow inside the house?
A warm environment might be just what Milky White needs to produce his milk.
It's a she! How many times must I tell you only she's can give milk?
Why, come in, little girl.
I wish. It's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. A loaf of bread, please, to bring my poor old hungry granny in the woods. Just a loaf of bread, please.
Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them out again in 2 hours' time, then you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bun or four.
Birds in the sky, birds in the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the castles and ponds.
And a few of those pies.
Come, little birds, down from the eaves and the leaves, over fields, out of castles and ponds.
No squeeze pads.
Flick through the ashes, pick and peck, but swiftly sift through the ashes into the pot.
Listen well, son. Milky White must be taken to market.
Mother, no! He's the best cow.
Was? She's been dry for a week. We've no food nor money, and no choice but to sell her, while she can still command a price.
But Milky White is my best friend in the whole world.
Look at her. There are bugs on her dugs. There are flies in her eyes. There's a lump on her rump, big enough to be a hump.
But
son, we've no time to sit and dither while her withers wither with her. And no one keeps a cow for a friend. Sometimes I fear you're touched.
Into the woods it's time to go. I hate to leave, I have to though. Into the woods it's time, and so I must begin my journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am expected, ma'am. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
Oh. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
You're certain of your way?
The way is clear, the light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees, the trees are just wood. I sort of hate to ask it, but do you have a basket?
Don't stray and be late.
Save some of those sweets for Granny.
Into the woods and down the dell, the path is straight, I know it well. Into the woods and who can tell what's waiting on the journey. Into the woods to bring some bread to Granny who is sick in bed. Never can tell what lies ahead, for all that I know she's already dead. But into the woods to grandmother's house and home before dark.
Back to the sky, back to the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the cat.
Hurry up and do my hair, Cinderella. Are you really wearing that?
Here I found a little tear, Cinderella. Can't you hide it with a hat?
You look beautiful.
I know.
She means me.
Put it in a twist.
Who'll be here? Mother said be nice, father said be good. That was always their advice. So be nice, Cinderella. Good, Cinderella. Nice, good, nice. What's the good of being good if everyone is blind and you're always left behind? Never mind, Cinderella. Kind, Cinderella. Nice, good, nice. Kind, good, nice.
No! Not that tight!
I'm sorry.
Claude.
Because the baker had lost his father and his mother in a baking accident. Well, at least that's what he believed. He was eager to have a family of his own and concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We have sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door! We have no bread.
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she'd placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and vinegars, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting through my rutabaga, raiding my arugula, and ripping up the rimpy and my jampi and my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him right there. Could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair, or a But I let him have the rampy and I'd lots to spare. Return, however, I said fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it square.
I had a brother.
No! But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, and that we all might live happily thereafter. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I had inherited that garden, my mother had warned me that I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the beans.
Beans!
The special beans! I let him go. I didn't know he stole my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall when bang, crash, the lightning flash. And well, that's another story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came. I made my claim. Don't take her with the baby, they shrieked and screeched, but I did, and I hid her where she'll never be reached. Your father cried, your mother died. For extra measure, I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mollified. And I laid a little spell on them. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one. But I'm telling you the same I tell kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.
Listen to me, Jack. Lead Milky White to market and fetch the best price you can. Take no less than £5. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Now, how much you to ask?
No more than five?
Less than five. Jack, 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 hid in a sack. The house is getting colder. This is not a time for dreaming. Chimney stack starting to crack. The mice are getting bolder. The floor's gone slack. Your mother's getting older. Your father's not back. And you can't just sit here dreaming pretty dreams. To wish and wait from day to day will never keep the wolves away. So into the woods, the time is now. We have to live, I don't care how. Into the woods to sell the cow. You must begin the journey. Straight through the woods and don't delay. We have to face the marketplace. Into the woods to journey's end.
Into the woods to sell a friend.
Someday you'll have a real pet, Jack.
A piggy?
Meanwhile, the witch, for purposes of her own, explained how the baker might lift the spell.
You wish to have the curse reversed. I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back. One, the cow as white as milk. Two, the cape as red as blood. Three, the hair as yellow as corn. Four, the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the time of midnight in 3 days' time. And you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be.
Thank you.
Thank you. Go to the wood.
Ladies, our carriage waits.
Now may I go to the festival?
The festival? Darling, those nails, darling, those clothes. Lentils are one thing, but darling, with those, you'd make us the fools of the festival and mortify the prince.
The carriage is waiting.
We must be gone.
Good night, Father. Oh, yeah. I wish.
Look what I found in Father's hunting jacket.
6 beans.
Yes! Yes, I wonder if they are.
Yes, the witch's beans. We'll take them with us.
No! You are not to come.
I know you are fearful of the woods at night.
No, the spell is on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
The spell is on our house. No. We must
lift the
spell.
You are not to come, and that is final now. What am I to return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk.
And so the baker reluctantly set off to meet the enchantress's demands. But as for Cinderella,
I still wish to go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk.
But how am I ever to get to the festival? I know I'll visit mother's grave, the baby, the hazel tree. Tell her I just want to go to the king's festival.
The hair. Into the woods, it's time to go. It may be all in vain, I know. Into the woods, but even so, I have to take the journey.
Into the woods, the path is straight. I know it well, but who can tell?
Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods to visit mother.
Into the woods to fetch the things.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival.
Into the woods without regret.
The choice is made, the task is set.
Into the woods, but not forgetting why I'm on the journey.
Into the woods to get our wish. I don't care how the time is now.
Into the woods to sell the cow.
Into the woods to get the money.
Into the woods to lift the spell.
To make the potion.
To go to the festival.
Into the woods to grandmother's house. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
The way is clear. The light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees. The trees are just wood. No need to be afraid there.
There's something in the glade there.
Into the woods without delay, but careful not to lose the way. Into the woods, who knows what may be lurking on the journey. Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journeying. Into the woods
to see the key, to sell the cow.
To make the potion,
to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to lift, to go to the festival. Into the woods.
Cinderella had planted a branch at the grave of her mother, And she visited there so often and wept so much that her tears watered it until it had become a handsome tree.
I've been good and I've been kind, Mother, doing only what I learned from you. Why then am I left behind, Mother? Is there something more that I should do? What is wrong with me, Mother? Something must be wrong. I wish... Oh,
what, child? Specify. Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor. And good fortune, like bad, can befall when least expected.
I wish...
Do you know what you wish? Are you certain what you wish is what you want? If you know what you want, then make a wish. Ask the tree, and you shall have your wish.
Shiver and quiver, little tree. Silver and gold throw down on me. I'm off to get my wish.
Quiet. Silence everywhere, Milky White. Not to my liking.
Hello, Jack.
How did you know my name?
When first I appear, I seem mysterious. But when explained, I'm nothing serious.
Say that again.
On your way to market? You might have been there long ago. You taking your time, Jack?
No, sir.
That's the truth?
Well, you see, no,
what are you asking for the animal?
No less than £5, sir.
Jack, why such a sum?
My mother told me...
Your mother? A boy your age? Why? You'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
Well, come along, Milky White. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further in the wood. Her house stands under three large oak trees.
Look at that flesh. Pink and plump, hello, little girl. Tender and fresh, not one lump, hello, little girl. This one's especially lush, delicious. Hello, little girl, what's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay or be misled.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first, then Miss Plump. What a delectable couple. Heart to perfection, one brittle, one supple, one moment, my dear.
Come with me, follow the path and never stray.
Just so, little girl, any path, so many worth exploring. Just one would be so boring. And look what you're ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones, then something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
Mother said not to stray. Still, I suppose a small delay. Granny might like a fresh bouquet. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl. And hello.
it's time to come to that little girl in the red cape.
Forget the little girl and get the cape.
You frightened me.
That's the cape. Get it. Get it. Get it.
How am I supposed to get it?
To go up to the little thing and to take it.
No. No, I can't just take a cloak from a little girl. Why don't you take it?
If I could, I would. But I can't. Music. Get me what I need. Get me what I need.
This is ridiculous. I'll never get that red cape, nor find a golden cow, or a yellow slipper, or was it a golden slipper and a yellow cow? Oh, no.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
What are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
Yes. No. You have no business being alone in the woods, and you have no idea what I have happened upon here. You would be frightened for your life. Now, go home immediately.
I wish to help.
No. The spell is on my house.
Our house.
Only I can lift the spell. The spell is on my house.
The spell is on who?
A cow as white as...
Look.
Hello there, young man.
Hello, sir.
What might you be doing with a cow in the middle of the forest?
I was heading toward market, but I seem to have lost my way.
What are you planning to do there?
Yes. What are you planning to do there?
Sell my cow, sir. Mm-hmm. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? Where am I to get 5 pounds?
Oh, she must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you cannot fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. Uh-huh. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans, we mustn't give up our beans. Oh, well, if you feel we must, son, beans will bring you food.
Beans? In exchange for my cow?
Well, these are no ordinary beans. Son, these beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him.
Magic that defies description.
Well, my mom told
me. You'd be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
Six.
No, five. We can't part with all of them. We must save one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say these beans are worth a pound each at the very least.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Possibly. Good luck there, young lad.
I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plate.
Quickly, take the cow and go home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beans. We've no reason to believe they're magic. Are we to dispel this curse through deceit?
Oh, no one would have given him more for this creature. Anyway, we did him a favor. At least they'll have some food.
5 beans.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you'll live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in-betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Why you do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look, she's crying.
If the thing you do is pure in intent, if it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only 3 more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize. If the end is right, it justifies the beast.
Quickly, free. Take the cow and go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cape as red as blood. Now, as for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower deep within the forest. And whenever the old enchantress wanted to pay a visit, she called for
Rapunzel! 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 Let down your hair to me.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what a strange name. Oh, strange but beautiful, fit for a prince. Tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I shall stand before her window and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Hello there, little one.
Hello.
Have you saved some of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets. And half the loaf of bread.
Oh, where did you get this beautiful cape? I so admire it.
My granny made it for me.
Is that right? I would love to have a red cloak like this.
You'd look pretty foolish.
May I take a look at it?
Oh, I don't like you without my cape. Please give it back.
No, I need it badly.
Give it back, please.
Forget the little girl and get the cape.
I just wanted to make sure you really love this cape. Now, you go to your granny's, and you be careful no wolf comes your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day.
No! Oh. If you know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak. What's a cloak? It's a joke. It's a stupid little cloak. And a cloak is what you make it. So you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker, with newfound determination, went after the red cape. As for the little girl, she was surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, Grandmother. My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But Grandmother, what big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
Grandmother, what large hands you have.
The better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, Grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have!
I'm better to eat you with!
And scarcely had the wolf said this than with a single bound, he was devouring the little girl. Well, it was a full day of eating for both. And with his appetite appeased, the wolf took to bed for a nice long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore. Odd. Where is the little one? Eating, no doubt. Or eaten. Grandmother, ha! What is that red cloth doing in the corner of your mouth? That looks to me to be a piece of... I will get the cape from within your stomach.
How dark and dank it was inside that wolf!
Kill the devil! Take that and I
his evil head off. Let's see the demon sliced into a thousand bits. No, no, better yet, let the animal die a painful, agonizing, hideous death.
Granny!
Yeah, quiet, child. This evil needs to be destroyed. Now, you fetch me some great stones. We'll fill his belly with them, and then we'll watch him try to run away.
I will just leave you to your task.
No, 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 wait. Wait, don't you want the skins?
Oh, no, please keep them.
Yeah, what kind of a hunter are you?
I'm a baker.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay or be misled. I should have heeded her advice, but he seemed so nice. And he showed me things, many beautiful things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were off my path, so I never had dared. I had been so careful, I never had cared. And he made me feel excited, well, excited and scared. When he said, come in, with that sickening grin, how could I know what was in store? Once his teeth were bare, though I really got scared, well, excited and scared, but he drew me close, and he swallowed me down, down a dark, slimy path, where lie secrets that I never want to know. And when everything familiar seemed to disappear forever, at the end of the path was Granny once again. So we wait in the dark until someone set us free, and we're brought into the light, and we're back at the start. And I know things now, many valuable things that I hadn't known before. Do not put your faith in a cape and a hood. They will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care with strangers, even flowers have their dangers. And though scary is exciting, nice is different than good. Now I know, don't be scared. Granny is right, just be prepared. Isn't it nice to know a lot? And a little bit not. Oh, Mr. Baker! You saved our lives. Here.
Are you certain?
Yes. Maybe Granny will make me another with the skin to that wolf.
No, no. Thank you. Thank you.
Now the baker, with the second article in hand, feeling braver and more satisfied than he'd ever felt, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack.
Oh, only adults would exchange a cow for beef.
No!
To bed without any supper for you.
And little did they know that those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Miss, are you all right?
Yes, I just need to catch my breath.
Oh, my. Oh, what a beautiful gown you're wearing.
Oh, thank you.
Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Oh, aren't you the lucky one? Whatever are you doing in the wood at this hour?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her over there.
Oh, I've never lied to royalty before.
Oh, thank you.
If a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
Well, what brings you here? And with a cow?
Oh. Well, my husband is in the woods somewhere. Oh. He's undoing a spell.
Oh, yes.
Ooh.
But the prince... The prince, what was he like?
He's a very nice prince.
And?
And?
It's a very nice ball. And?
And? When I entered, they trumpeted.
And? The prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes. And?
And it made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
He has charm for a prince, I guess.
Guess?
I don't meet a wide range. And it's all very strange.
Are you to attend the festival tomorrow eve?
Oh, perhaps.
Perhaps. To be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Will you look over there? An enormous vine growing next to that little cottage.
I mean slippers.
It looks like a giant beanstalk rising into the sky.
As pure as gold. I must get home.
I need your shoe.
What midnight's gone?
No knot unties itself.
Sometimes the things you most wish for are not to be touched.
The harder to get, the better to have. Agreed? Agreed.
Never wear mauve at a ball.
Or pink.
Or open your mouth.
The difference between a cow and a bean is a bean can begin an adventure.
Slotted spoons don't hold much soup.
The prettier the flower, the farther from the path.
The closer to the family, the closer to the wine.
One midnight gone.
The mouth of a wolf's not the end of the world.
A servant is not just a dog to a prince.
Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor.
You may know what you need, but to get what you want, better see that you keep what you have.
One midnight gone.
The harder
to get, the better to have.
To get what you want, better
see.
One midnight gone. One midnight gone. Into the woods. Into the woods. Into the woods and out of the woods and home before.
There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you'd never dare, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. She gives you food and she gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you've made a friend and all, and you know she's big but you don't feel small, someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you've known and the world you left, the little you own. The fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Good for
fortune. Good fortune, sir. Look what I have. Here are 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She allowed me these 5 to do with as I pleased.
Oh, my.
Where is Milky White?
Milky White is back home with my wife.
Let's go find them.
Oh, no, no. I don't know that I wish to sell.
You said that I might buy her back.
I know, but I don't know that 5 gold pieces...
Are you saying that you wish more money?
More money?
Keep this, and I will go fetch more.
Oh, no, 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 wait! Wait! I didn't say that I would... Five gold pieces. With this money, I could buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a new thatched
roof. What could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. When explained, I'm nothing serious. Would you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I've not thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. You've not thought about many things, have you, son?
Oh, give me back the money that is not yours.
Nor is it Jack's. The money is not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
But I want the money back. Come back here. What are you doing here now?
I see you have the red cape.
Yes. Yes, I've the cape. I've only 2 items left to locate.
3.
2. I've the cow and the cape.
You have the cape.
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away before I reached home. I have been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have entrusted her to you.
She might just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
Well, she might have.
But she didn't.
Cow.
She did not run.
Kids! The cow is gone! Get it back! Get it back!
We were just going to do that. Look. I could give you this.
I don't want to touch that fool. Having no sense. My sweetness calls. She's over there. By tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items, or you'll wish you never thought to have a child.
No! Oh. I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry that I lost the cow.
Yes, yes, I shouldn't have yelled. And now please go back to the village. Quickly, please. I will make things right. And then we can just go about our lives. No more hunting in the woods for strange objects. No more witches, or dim-witted boys, or hungry little girls.
Go!
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you had gone.
I've been looking all night for her.
Her?
Yes, the beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Well, where did she go?
Disappeared, like the fine morning mist.
Well, she was lovely.
The loveliest.
Oh, I'm not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, in the top of a tall tower that has no door or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
Oh, I stand before her window and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what kind of a name is that? You jest. I have never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. And she is as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair.
blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Agony far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony, all the torture they teach. What's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome and heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her agony, misery, although it's different for each. Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to watch.
Is each more handsome than the other. No, get the hair.
Excuse me, young woman!
Have you encountered a boy with carrot-top hair and a sunny, though occasionally vague, disposition answering to the name of Jack?
Not the one partial to a white cow?
He's the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again. Children can be very queer about their animals. You be careful with your children.
I have no children.
That's okay, too.
Yes, well, I'm sorry. Very sorry. I've not seen your son today.
I hope he didn't go up that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack!
Moo. Moo.
Moo. Looking for your cow.
Yeah. Where did you find her? Hello? Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to stay out of this, old man.
I'm here to see that you get your wish.
You have caused enough trouble. You keep out of my path.
Oh, and now let's see. If that was the mossy knoll, then this must be the tower. Oh, I certainly hope there are no witches to be encountered here. Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me.
Is that you, my prince?
Yes.
Oh, 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 my. Oh, yeah. Oh, excuse me for this.
Ah!
Oh. Well, my goodness, you do take plenty of spills, don't you?
It's these slippers. They're not suited for these surroundings. Actually, they're not much suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers were as pure as gold.
Oh, yes. They are all you could wish for in beauty.
Oh, what I wouldn't give for just one.
Well, one is not likely to do you much good.
Oh. Was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes, and?
And they have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh, who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
Oh, he must really have taken a liking to you. Oh,
yes, but I have no experience with princes and castles and gowns and things.
Oh, nonsense. Every girl dreams of just those things. You would be so...
Are you kidding? Yes,
yes, yes. Jack, oh, please.
Stop, no, no, no.
She go.
Ooh. Don't play the fool, woman.
Oh, yes, of course. I'm sorry. You mean the beautiful, the maiden, the young, the maiden in the ball gown. She went in that direction. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can capture my own damsel. Thank you.
Oh, where did he go?
Who?
The prince, of course.
That direction, you'll never reach him.
Oh, well, we would have if that mongrel with the cow hadn't molested us.
Oh, please. Please, let me just compare this color to that of your own, please. I thought you were returning home. I've had no luck.
You've the cow.
Yes, I've the cow. I've only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Yeah. Three.
Oh, and I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
We've an entire day left. Surely we can find the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Perhaps it will take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough. It's not true. It takes two of us. You came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you swear to change, you can tell if you do. It takes two.
You've changed. You're thriving. There's something about the woods. Not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. At home, I'd fear we'd stay the same forever. And then, out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
It takes one to begin, but then once you've begun, it takes two of you. It's no fun, but what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us as a pair of us. It's accepting a share of what's there.
We've changed. We're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who minds what dangers? I know we'll get past the woods. And what?
changes last. Beyond woods, beyond witches and slippers and hoes, just the two of us, beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us, it takes trust, it takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we have none, we've got three, we need one, it takes two.
My milky white and the owners and my hand.
Oh! Oh, look what this hen has dropped in my hands.
A golden egg.
Yes.
I've never seen a golden egg.
You see, I promised you more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
Now I'm taking my cow.
5 gold pieces?
I never said I would sell.
You took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces?
No, I did not take, you gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
There was this mysterious
you
old
said,
man.
What are you
who
saying?
I could
you're
have.
Money
I
could have seen.
Milky White is dead.
Oh, two.
Two. Midnight's gone.
Wanting a ball is not wanting a prince.
Near may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
Near may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
The ball.
So near, so far.
You can never love somebody else's child.
Two midnight's
the
gone.
Way you love.
The greatest prize can often lie at the end of a thorniest path.
Two midnights gone.
Two midnights gone.
Two midnights gone. And the exhausted baker and his wife had buried the dead Milky White.
Go. Go, you must go to the village in search of another cow.
Oh, and what do you propose I use to purchase this cow?
Here. Tell them it's magic.
No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a cow for a bean.
Then steal it.
Oh, steal it. Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercising deceit in securing the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
All right. I feel it best. You go for the cow, as I have met a maiden with a golden slipper these previous eves, and I think I might succeed in winning one of her shoes.
Fine.
Fine.
Fine. That is simply fine.
Must listen.
No, no, please.
What we have not to do, children must see and learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. Ashamed. You don't understand.
It was lonely atop that tower.
I was not company enough.
I am no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me. Princes wait there in the world, it's true. Yes, but wolves and humans too. Stay at home. I am home. Who out there could love you more than I? What out there that I cannot supply? Stay.
I gave you protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
Oh, no.
Why?
No.
Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor? I will not share you, but I will show you a world you've never seen.
When is a white cow not a white cow?
I don't know. Leave me alone.
Haven't I left you alone long enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In need of another cow.
What a beautiful cape!
Stay away from my cape, or I'll slice you into 1,000 bits.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made this for me from a wolf that attacked us, and I got to skin the animal. And best of all, she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have. A hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where did you get that egg?
I stole this from the kingdom of the giant up there. And if you think this is something, you should see the golden harp the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without your even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I am not a liar. I'll get that harp. You'll see.
Now, having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise, and as he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought. What would be his response? But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick? Where you're safe out of sight and yourself, but where everything's wrong? Or where everything's right and you know that you'll never belong? And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting and all. Once you're there, though, it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, cause you're still standing stuck in the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes. Then from out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue. For example, a shoe. And then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew. On the steps of the palace.
Any closer,
to
me. Oh, no, please, just hear me out.
We have nothing to discuss. You have attacked me once before.
I did not attack you. I attacked your shoe. I need it. Here. Here is a magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean? Nonsense.
Oh, don't do that.
I have already given up one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to give up another.
No. Oh, no, please, please. I need that shoe to have a child.
Well, that makes no sense.
Well, does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
Stella!
Oh, no, no, miss. Here, here, take my shoes. You'll run faster.
Who was that woman?
I do not know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I swear I've done nothing.
Hide the cow.
Where's the slipper? We've all four.
I will take this to the prince, and tomorrow we will search the kingdom for the maiden who will fit this shoe.
Give her the slipper and all will come to a head.
Woman, I must have this.
What was that noise?
That was just a bolt of lightning in a far-off kingdom.
How dare you go off in search without me?
My apologies, sir. I thought I might...
Enough of what you thought!
I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch, and there, when she ran down, remained the maiden's slipper.
Brilliant!
I thought so. It did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
And I have succeeded in obtaining the other slipper.
Well, give them the slipper and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem deleterious.
Shut up!
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
Yes, sir.
Down the stalk. Suddenly, with a crash, the beanstalk fell, but there was no Jack. For all I know, he's been crushed by the ogre.
Worrying will do you no good. If he's safe, then he's safe. If he's been crushed, well, then there's nothing any of us can do about that now, is there? We must be off! I need my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Doesn't anyone care? A giant has fallen from the sky!
The third midnight is near! I see a cow, I see a slipper!
And the cape is red as blood.
Hair as yellow as corn.
Give all the objects!
Yes!
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Yes, oh, yes. She is.
Skullsman, come up with flour!
No, we had a cow as white as milk. Honestly, we did.
Then where is she?
She's dead.
We thought you would prefer a live
one. Of course I prefer a live one, so bring me the dead one and I'll bring her back to life.
You can do that.
No!
There you are! I've been worried sick!
Mother, look, the most beautiful harp.
You've stolen too much. You could have been killed coming down that plank.
She's too heavy.
What's happening, Mother? Milky White! Now I have two friends, a cow and a harp.
Quiet! Feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me. Feed them to the cow. Fill this.
I'll do it. She'll only milk for me.
Quickly.
Hurry, please hurry.
Squeeze, pal.
Child!
you doing there?
Oh, nothing, I swear, just passing by.
I touched that hair! Don't you understand? I cannot have touched the ingredients!
The corn! The corn! You'll certainly have the corn. Pull it from the ear, feed it to the cow, quickly.
Quickly, hurry.
This had better work, old man, before the last stroke of midnight. Or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son?
Please, not now.
Yes! Meet your father.
Father! How could that be you? I thought you died in a baking accident.
I did not mean to run away from you, son.
It's working! But,
she's milking!
I don't understand.
No, not now. Into the gap, into the gap.
Wait, Father, wait. Is she milking? It's working. We did it. We did it.
Son!
Father!
Son, all is repaired.
Father! Father! He's dead!
And so the mysterious old man died, having helped end the curse on his house. For the baker, there would be no reunion with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, having been punished with age and ugliness that fateful night when her beans were stolen and the lightning flashed, was now restored to her former state of youth and beauty. Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with a now wealthy Jack. As for the prince, he began his search for the foot to fit the golden slipper. Now, when he reached Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took the slipper into Florinda's room.
Careful, my toe!
Darling, I know.
What'll we do?
It'll have to go, but when you're his bride, you can sit or ride. You'll never need to walk.
And swallowed her pain, joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his bride.
Look at the blot within the shoe. This one is not the bride, that's true. Search for the foot that offends.
The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the shoe.
Why won't it fit?
Darling, be still. Cut off a bit of the heel and it will. And when you're his wife, you'll have such a life, you'll never need to walk.
No, no, no.
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain. But as she was helped on the back of the horse by the prince, he noticed the blood trickling from the shoe.
Have you no other daughter?
To which the woman replied,
no, only a little stunted kitchen wench, which his late wife left behind. But she's much too dirty. She cannot show herself.
I insist.
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I always wanted a son.
And much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, the prince took Cinderella on his horse and rode off.
Blood at all within the shoe. This is the proper bride for you, fit to attend a prince.
And finally, as for Rapunzel, she bore twins and lived impoverished in the desert, until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard that voice so familiar that he went towards it. As he approached, Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell into his arms, weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes, and their touch restored his vision.
I was going to come fetch you just as soon as you learned your lesson.
Who are you?
Surely you remember.
Mother?
This is who I truly am! Come with me, child! We can be happy as we once were!
She will not go with you!
Let her speak for herself! You are the only family I know. Come with me. Please.
You give me no choice! Bah!
As is often the way in these tales, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her powers. When the wedding with the prince was celebrated, Lucinda and Florinda attended, hoping to win favor with Cinderella and share in her good fortune. But as the sisters stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down upon them, poked out their eyes, and blinded them.
I see your prince has found you.
Yes.
Thank you for the slipper.
I didn't think I'd wed a prince.
I didn't think I'd ever find you.
I didn't think we could be so happy.
And it came to pass, all that seemed wrong was now right. The kingdoms were filled with joy, and those who deserved to were certain to live a long and happy life. Ever after.
Ever after.
Journey over, all is mended, and it's not just for today, but tomorrow and extended ever after.
Ever after.
All the curses have been ended, the reverses wiped away. All is tenderness and laughter for forever after.
Happy now and happy and so happy ever after.
There were dangers and confusions, and the paths would often swerve. There were constant disillusions, but they never lost their nerve, and they reached the right conclusions.
And we got what we deserve. Not a sigh and not a sorrow, tenderness and laughter. Joy today and bliss tomorrow and forever after.
I was greedy.
I was vain.
I was haughty.
I was smug. We were happy. It was fun.
We were blind.
Then we went into the woods to get our wish, and now we're really blind.
I was perfect. I had everything but beauty. I had power. And a dog like a flower in a tower. Then I went into the woods to get my wish, and now I'm ordinary. Lost my power and my flower.
Happy now and happy and so as well as ever.
Though it's dark, and though you may lose the path, though you may cover
holes, though it's deep, you must go far, you must go far. Into the woods and down the dell, and vain perhaps, but who can tell? Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods to lose the lorry.
Into the woods to have the child.
To wed the prince.
To get the money.
To save the house.
To kill the wolf.
To find the father.
To conquer the kingdom. To have to wait. To get, to save, to kill, to keep, to go to the festival. Into the woods. Into the woods. Into the woods. Then out of the woods.
To be continued.
And happy ever after.
Once upon a time. Later.
I wish.
In that same far-off kingdom.
More than anything.
Lived the young princess.
More than life.
The lad Jack.
More than foot.
I wish.
And the baker with his family.
No, I miss.
I wish.
More than anything.
More than the moon.
I wish to sponsor a festival.
More than life.
I miss. The time has come for a festival.
More than riches.
And a ball.
I miss my kingdom up in the sky.
More than anything.
I wish we had more room.
Another room.
But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all quite content.
I never thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy.
Not an unhappy moment since.
I didn't think we'd be this
rich. Not a conceivable objection.
I never thought we'd have a baby.
I didn't know I could be so happy.
Little gurgles.
And darling, I must go now.
We should really sell it.
Where's the cheesecloth?
Wishes may bring problems such that you regret them. Better that though than to never get them.
I'm going to be a perfect wife.
I'm going to be the perfect
son. I'm going to be a perfect wife.
I'm going to see that he is so happy.
I never thought I'd love my life. I would have settled for a
set for love,
then to begin a child, that fortune smile, I'm so happy.
Oh, if only this cottage were a little larger.
I will expand our quarters in due time.
Why expand when we could simply move to another cottage?
No, we will not move. This was my father's house, and now it will be my son's.
And you would raise your child alongside a witch?
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Baby's cry, he's fine. You know, you needn't hold him as if he were so fragile.
No, he wants his mother.
No, please. I cannot take care of him all of the time.
I will care for him when he is older.
We had to go through thick and thin.
We had to lose a lot to win.
I wish I'd always been.
I never thought I'd be so much I hadn't been. I'm so happy.
Are you all right?
I think so.
And the baby.
Yes, no,
is the baby all right?
Yes, sir.
Hugh! Have you done this to our house?
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden.
What of your garden?
Look.
Destroyed.
What has happened?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
What could do such a thing?
An earthquake.
No, earthquake. My garden has been trampled. Those are footprints.
Who could do such a thing?
Anything that leaves a footprint that large is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
A bear? Bears are sweet. Besides, you ever see a bear with 40-foot feet?
Dragon?
No scorch marks. Usually they're linked.
Manticore?
Imaginary.
Griffin?
Extinct.
Giant?
Possible. Very, very possible.
A giant.
Maybe we should tell someone. Mm.
Who are you going to tell?
The royal family, of course.
The royal family? I wouldn't count on them to snuff out a rat. With a giant, we'll all have to go to battle. Giant's the worst. Giant has a brain. Hard to outwit. A giant. A giant's just like us. Only bigger. Much, much bigger. So be. That we are just an expendable bug beneath its foot. Boom!
lunch.
We are moving.
And so the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Look, Milky White, it's the butcher.
The baker.
The baker.
What can we do for you, sir?
I am here to investigate the destruction that was wrought upon our house today.
Jack has been home with me all day.
The baker told Jack and his mother that he feared there was a giant in the land.
I can recognize a giant's footsteps. I could go to your house.
No such thing!
Any help at all
I'm
that
sorry,
your son...
But you'll get none from us. No one cared when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you volunteering to come to my aid.
A giant in your backyard is one thing. A crushed home is quite another.
Look, young man, giants never strike the same house twice. I wouldn't worry.
I am taking the news to the castle nonetheless.
And when the baker arrived at the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This small man insists on seeing you.
Oh, princess! I am here to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
I didn't exactly see it.
Then how do you know there is a giant in the land?
Because our house was destroyed. And there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I will show you
to the
door.
No. A nearby household was visited by a giant. And not long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Oh, yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now, come on.
No, wait, please, wait. We have a young child. Princess, please. Our child was very difficult to come by. And his safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm going off to market, Jack.
Goodbye, Mother.
Now, I want you to stay inside.
I haven't been outside all day.
Oh, Jack, listen to me. I don't want you out when there might be a giant on the loose.
Mother, I know how to kill a giant.
Please, we've had our fill of giants.
But Mother...
Enough! Promise me, son, you won't leave your surroundings.
But Mother, I'm a man now.
You're still a little boy in your mother's eyes. I want you to promise. Promise!
All right, I promise.
What happened to your house?
We've had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
Well, there's no use frightening the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to do without the bread and sweets. Besides, I have all I can carry.
My goodness, why such a load?
Oh, well, I'm moving in with Granny. We had an accident, too. I came home to find our house collapsed as if a big wind blew it in. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh, no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off.
Oh, good friends. What news have you? What of Mother's grave? What kind of trouble? Oh, no, I can't investigate. A princess is not supposed to go into the woods unescorted. Oh, good idea. I will disguise myself and go to see what's wrong. Oh, thank you, birds.
We'll take you to Granny's.
What?
We're not going to let her go alone.
All right. I will take you.
I don't need anyone to take me. I've gone many times before.
Well, not when such winds have been blowing.
That's right. We'll all take you.
No.
I'm not about to stay here with the baby when a wind might return to this house, too.
I know Mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you think at last you're through, and then into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the weather's clear, we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here.
Into the woods to find the giant.
Into the woods to Grandmother's house.
Into the woods, the path is straight, no reason then to hesitate.
Into the woods, it's not so late, it's just another journey.
Into the woods, but not too long, the skies are strange, the winds are strong. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
Into the woods to slay the giant.
Into the woods to shield the child.
To flee the wind.
To find the future.
To shield.
Slay.
Flee.
To find.
To fix.
To hide.
To move.
To battle.
To see what the trouble is.
Rapunzel!
nothing. You just locked me in a tower without company for 14 years, then blinded my prince and banished me to a desert where I had little to eat and again no company, and then bore twins. Because of the way you treated me, I'll never, never be happy.
I was just trying to be a good mother. Stay with me. There's a giant rebuffing of vows.
Brother, what a surprise.
Mother, how good to see you.
What brings you to the wood today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
You investigating news of a giant?
Yes.
Why, Father would not even do that. That's business for your steward or less.
Well, what brings you into the wood?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
Oh, she's a changed woman. Subject to hysterical fits of crying, moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell me what you're really doing here.
High in a tower, like yours was, but higher, a beauty asleep. All round the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen, when the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden, alas, just as unwakeable.
What unmistakable agony is the way always barred.
She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony, such that princes must weep. Always enthralled, most to anything, almost or something asleep. If it were not for the thicket,
a thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest,
the quickest is pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarves.
Dwarfs, dwarfs.
Dwarfs are very upsetting. Not forgetting the task's unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable. Agony, misery, not to know what you miss, while they lie there for years,
and you cry on their beers, what unbearable bliss.
Agony that can cut like a knife. Ah, well, back to my wife.
Rapunzel. I must be off. Godspeed to you, brother.
Godspeed!
Are you certain this is the right direction?
We went down the dell.
Perhaps you forgot the way.
The path is straight.
No, no, no. What's straight? Well, there is no path.
Well, where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Just calm down. Maybe we should turn back.
No.
No, 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 no. No. We will just have to find Granny's without the path.
But Mother warned me she never strayed from the path.
The path has strayed from you.
Oh, wait. That looks familiar. You see in the distance, 3 oak trees.
Well, yes, I recognize that.
Who might that be?
That's the steward in the royal family. What brings you into the woods?
The castle. The castle has been set upon by a giant.
No.
I warned you. Why didn't you do something?
I don't make policy. I just carry it out.
And I warned you. You can't count on a royal family to solve your problems.
All right, I think it best we return to the village right now.
I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle.
What do you mean?
All that's left of my garden is a sack of beans. And there's not much left of your house either.
No, I was told giants rarely strike the same house twice.
Shh, listen.
The giant's a woman!
That sigh.
Where is the lad who killed my husband?
There is no lad here!
We haven't seen him!
I want the lad who climbed the beanstalk!
We'll get him for you right away! Don't move!
It was you who destroyed our house, not a great wind!
Destroyed my house. That boy asked for shelter. Then he stole our gold, our hen, and our harp. Then he killed my husband. I must avenge the wrongdoing.
We are not responsible for him.
You're wasting your breath.
She's right. You can't reason with a dumb giant.
Not all giants are dumb now. Give me the boy.
We told you he's not here.
The girl is telling the truth.
I know he's there, and I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me.
Now, the giant, who was nearsighted and had lost her glasses, remained convinced that she'd found the lad, and there was no consensus among them which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her.
I no longer have my powers. If I did, you think I'd be standing here with all of you? Now, we'll have to give her someone. The steward, it's in his line of duty to sacrifice his life.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
Oh, I'm waiting.
Now, you must understand, these were not people familiar with making choices. Their experience in the woods in no way prepared them for a force this great.
Excuse me. Would you like a blind girl instead?
How dare you!
Put them out of their misery!
We're not that miserable. What are you talking about? She doesn't want a woman.
Fine. What do you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
It's interesting to examine the moral issue involved here. Now, the finality of stories such as these dictates... What? No. Sorry. I tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right.
Not one of us.
Only from the outside.
Well, that's my job. Don't you understand? There must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
You're making a big mistake.
Nonsense.
There must always be an outside observer to pass the story along.
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
You drag me into this, you'll never know how the story turns out. You'll be lost.
Wait, he's right. He's the only one that knows the story.
You think it'll be fun telling this yourself? Now think of your child.
Yes, he's right. He's right. Leave him alone. You put that away, young lady.
You don't want to live in a world of chaos.
Here's the lad!
Ah!
I've got the lad!
This is not the lad!
Don't drop!
Why? Why did you push him into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of him, too.
Well, we might have thought of something else.
If it were up to you, a decision would never be made.
Well, now that he's gone, we'll never know what will happen next.
Don't say that. We'll manage.
Oh, must I search among you for the lad?
No, he's just a boy. We had no food to eat, and he sold his beloved cow in exchange for magic beans. If anyone is to be punished, it's the man that made that exchange.
Oh, that's right.
It was your responsibility. Now I must punish him for his wrongs.
We've suffered too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You are getting me angry.
I'll hide my son, and you'll never find him.
don't upset the
you'll
giant.
You'll never, never find
I'm
him.
I'm warning you.
Don't hold back this instant. We'll get you for all that you've done. We'll burn.
Where is your son?
Ah! Is that him?
No! No! No!
The boy's hiding in the steeple tower!
Well, if he is not, I will return and find you.
Rapunzel!
Come.
Sir.
No! Rapunzel!
No! Don't step on the...
She's in poor condition.
Wake up.
Don't let them get Jack.
Oh, we won't.
Promise me you won't let him be hurt as I stand here at death's door.
I'll do all I can.
Promise. Promise!
It's all right, I promise.
Jack. Jack.
No, 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 come away from there. You! Oh, you killed her.
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
Return to normal.
We must be gone if we're to arrive before nightfall.
Well, where are you going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom.
Shh! We can't take everyone.
Fools, there's nowhere to hide.
She'll never get there. We have to stay here and find a way out of this together.
Some people are cut out to battle giants and others are not. I don't have the constitution. And as long as I can be of no help, I'm going to hide. Now, everything will work out fine in the end.
Not always.
I hope the giant steps on them all.
You shouldn't say that.
You were thinking the same thing.
Well, this is terrible. We just saw three people die.
Since when are you so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf's not the same.
Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop it.
I suggest we find that boy now and give her what she wants.
If we give her the boy, she'll kill him, too.
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
All right, one step at a time here. Now, maybe. Maybe if the boy apologizes and makes amends...
Yes, he'll return the stolen goods.
Yes, she's a very smart boy.
The harp and the
hand. People are so blind! It's because of that boy there's a giant in our land. While you continue talking about this problem, I'll find that lad and I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
Well... are we going to let her feed him to the giant?
No.
No, I will have to find him first.
I'll go too.
No. You stay here with the baby.
No, we'll fan out. It will increase our chances of finding the boy.
But what if one of us were to get lost?
No, we'll count our steps from right here. No, not you. I need you to stay here and watch the baby. And I do not want you roaming about the woods. You understand me? Good girl.
What's that?
that you will leave our child with her.
Yes, the baby's asleep. He will be safe with the girl.
No, but what if the giant were to return here?
Well, the giant will not harm them. I know this.
How do you know?
I know.
No, but what if?
Oh, what if? Well, only a giant's foot stop your arguing. 100 paces. Go.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Hello?
Oh, you must be here to slay the giant.
Yes.
Have you come upon the giant yet?
No.
I have.
You have?
Yes.
And why are you alone in the woods?
Oh, I came with my husband. It's a long story. 83, 84.
He would let you roam alone. In the woods.
No, actually, that's my choice. I'm looking for a lad that
your
the giant...
Your choice?
Yes.
How brave.
Oh, brave.
Yes. Oh. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
This is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story. No, wait, one moment, please, sir. We can't do this. You have a princess.
Well, yes, I do.
And I have a baker.
Well, of course, you're right. How foolish. Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please. Let your hesitations be hushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment. After all, seize the moment. Skies may fall any moment.
No. This is not right.
Right and wrong don't matter in the woods. Only feelings let us meet the moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment present as a present for the moment.
Jack! Jack!
81, 82, 83, 84, 85. Jack! What's wrong, ma'am? May I be of some service?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
I'm sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Oh, no, no, don't say that.
It's true. Oh, you wouldn't understand.
Well, you can't stay here. There is a giant on the loose.
Well, I'm certain the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
There has been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off somewhere seducing some young maiden.
What?
As I understand, that's what princes do.
Well, not every prince.
You look just like the princess, but dirty. You are the princess!
Oh, no, get up.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, please get up. I'm not a princess here.
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
You haven't heard. We came upon the royal family. The castle has been set upon by the giant.
No! Oh, and the prince?
No. No, he was not with them.
Oh, my God.
Please, you must come with me. You will be safe in our company. This direction, quickly.
I must leave you.
Why?
The giant?
Oh, yes. The giant. I had almost forgotten. Will we find each other in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. How a moment shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now I must go off to slay a giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall not forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods, and how alive you've made me feel.
What was that?
Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me, and kiss me. And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up, stop dreaming, stop prancing about the woods. It's not beseeming, what is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband, you can't live in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for warmth and a baker for bread and a prince for whatever. Never it's these woods. Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods. Was that him? Yes, it was. Was that me? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the woods. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never? And that's what woods are for those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, then you'd never know you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment. Who can live in the woods? And to get what you wish only just for a moment, these are dangerous woods. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an and when you're back to or. Makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand, and it's time to leave the woods.
She should be back by now.
She wouldn't get lost.
I'm sure she'll return.
No, no, I must go in search of her.
We'll come too.
You yes. Stay here. I will count 100 paces and I shall return soon.
Look who I found.
Please don't let her give me to the giant.
Oh, it's not our fault. The giant wants you.
You're hurting me.
Let go of him.
Alone.
Where did you find this? Jack?
Where is my wife?
She's dead.
What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her and she was under a tree.
He was sobbing over her like she was his own mother.
Oh, how awful.
How could this happen? I should never have let her wander off alone.
I buried her in a footprint.
I should have insisted that she stay home.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now it's time to get this boy to the giant before we're all so much dead meat.
No, you keep away from him.
This is no time to be soft-hearted. He's going to the giant and I'm taking
him. Yes! Yes, he's the one to blame! It's because of you there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault. I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans. And without those beans, there'd have been no stalk to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute. Magic beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they oversold? Or tell us who persuaded you to steal that gold?
See, it's your fault.
No.
So it's your fault?
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute. But I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault?
Yes.
No, it isn't. I'd have kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It's your father. It's his fault that the curse got placed and the place got cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
So,
it was his fault.
No.
Yes, it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute, though. I chopped on the beanstalk, right? That's clear. But without any beanstalk, then what's queer is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Second place.
Yes, how?
Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean.
The other bean.
You pocketed the other bean.
I didn't. Yes, I did.
So it's yours.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So it's hers.
No, it isn't.
Who is it?
Wait a minute. She exchanged that bean to obtain your shoe, so the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife. Oh dear, but I never knew when so is it. Well, don't look here.
So it's your fault.
But it,
see, it's her fault.
But,
and it isn't mine at all.
But what?
Well, if you hadn't gone back up again.
You were needy.
You were greedy. Did you need that hen?
But I got it for my mother.
So it's her fault, then.
There's a little mother harp in the third place.
Harp, yes. Shh, you wouldn't dare me to.
I dare you to.
You dare me to. She said that I was scared to. You dare me.
No, I didn't.
So
it's your fault. Wait a minute.
You hadn't dared him to.
And you had left the harp alone.
Well, if you hadn't thrown away the bean in the first place.
She hadn't raised
the
bean.
Yes, she hadn't raised the bean.
She hadn't raised the bean in the first place.
You're responsible.
It's the last midnight. It's the last
wish.
It's the last midnight. Soon it will be boom, squish. Told a little lie. Stole a little gold, broke a little vow. Did you? Had to get your prince, had to get your cow. Have to get your wish, doesn't matter how. Anyway, it doesn't matter now. It's the last midnight. It's the boom splat. Nothing but a vast midnight. Everybody smashed flat. Nothing we can do, not exactly true. We can always give her the boy. No, no, of course what really matters is the blame. Somebody do blame. Fine, if that's the thing you enjoy, placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Just give me the boy.
No! No.
No. You're so nice. You're not good, you're not bad, you're just nice. I'm not good, I'm not nice, I'm just right. I'm the witch, you're the world. I'm the hitch, I'm what no one believes. I'm the witch, you're all liars and thieves like his father. Like his son will be too old. Why bother? You'll just do what you do. It's the last midnight. So goodbye, all. Coming at you fast, midnight. Soon you'll see the sky fall. Here you want a bean. Have another bean.
green. Beans are made for making you rich. Plant them and they soar. Here you want some more. Listen to the roar, giant's brother scroll. Oh, well, you can blame another witch. It's the last midnight. It's the last burst. Now before it's past midnight, I'm leaving you my last curse. I'm leaving you alone. You can tend the garden, it's yours, separate and alone. Everybody down on all fours. All right, mother went, lost the beans again. Punish me the way you did that. Give me claws and a hunch, just away from this bunch. And the gloom, and the doom, and the boom.
Maybe I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes. Maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had to find our way out of this together.
No, it doesn't matter whether we're together or apart.
We need your help.
You don't understand. My wife was the one who really helped. I depended on her for everything.
You would leave your child.
I think my child will be happier in the arms of a princess.
No, but wait!
I thought you were dead.
Not completely. Are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that true?
It's because of you that all of this has happened.
I climbed into the garden to steal your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those beans for myself. How was I to know? How are we ever to know? When she died, I ran from my guilt. Now, aren't you doing the same thing?
No.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions, please. No more tests. Comes the day you say, what for? Please. No more.
They disappoint, they disappear, they die, but they don't.
What?
They disappoint, in turn, I fear, forgive though they won't.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo. Left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more feelings. Time to shut the door. Just no more.
Running away, let's do it. Free from the ties that bind. No more despair or burdens to bear out there in the yonder. Running away, go to it. Where did you have in mind? Have to take care, unless there's a where, you'll only be wandering blind. Just more questions, different kind. Where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, we'll do it. Why sit around resigned? Trouble is, son, the farther you run, the more you feel undefined. For what you have left undone, and more, what you've left behind. We disappoint, we leave a mess, we die, but we don't.
We disappoint in turn, I guess, forget though we won't.
Like father, like son.
No more giants waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives till that happy day arrives? How do you ignore all the witches, all the curses, all the wolves, all the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses, all the wondering what, even worse, is still in store? All the children, all the giants, no
his baby.
He looked like he was going to.
Give me my son. Oh, he always cries when I hold him.
Well, now what are we to do?
We must have a plan before the giant returns.
What?
We must all think.
If there were just some way we could surprise her.
She's too tall to surprise.
Oh, good friends. I need your help now more than ever.
What of the prince?
I don't care. What's important now is that we find a way to fell the giant. How can you help?
You could do that?
How can I ever thank you?
You can talk to birds.
Help.
How?
Now, when the giant returns, they'll attack her and peck out her eyes and blind her.
But what good will that do?
Then you can surprise her. Or strike her, or whatever you do to kill a giant.
No, but once she's blind, she will stagger about.
She'll get angry.
She'll crush us all.
Smear the ground with pitch.
Yes.
We will lure her to an area smeared with pitch.
Yes, her shoes will stick and she won't be able to move.
And I will climb a tree and strike her from behind.
And I will be up there, too. It may take two mighty blows.
I'm excited.
We're going to kill the giant.
All right, quick. It will be dark soon. We must find the pitch.
There's some at Granny's.
This direction, quickly. Oh, no.
What is it?
I think the baby will be safest here with you.
Right.
This will take no time. Careful.
Oh, now there. Oh, don't cry, little one. Shh. I know you want your mother.
Hello?
The giant went in that direction.
My darling, I did not recognize you. What are you doing in your old clothes and with a child? You must go back to the castle at once. There's a giant on the loose.
Been to the castle.
No. Are you all right? I love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love. Am I?
I love you. I do. But yes, it's true.
Why, if you love me, would you have strayed?
I thought if you were mine that I would never wish for more. And part of me is content and as happy as I've ever been. But there remains a part of me that continually needs more.
I have on occasion wanted more, but that doesn't mean I went in search of it. If this is how you behave as a prince, what kind of king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. And I didn't ask to be born a king. I'm not perfect. I'm only human.
I think you should go.
Leave? But I do love you.
Consider I've been lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you really wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream. Now I want something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince.
They're almost finished. You see over there, between those two trees? Well, when the giant comes, we're to send her over there.
Good.
I wanted to climb the tree, too.
No, I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone.
Oh, no! Oh, I'm so sorry.
I think my granny and my mother would be angry with me.
Why?
Well, they said to always make them proud. And here I'm about to kill somebody.
Oh, not somebody. A giant who has been doing harm.
But the giant's a person. Aren't we to show forgiveness? Mother would be very unhappy with these circumstances.
Mother cannot guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you. Still you're not alone. No one is alone. Truly, no one is alone. Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wood. Others may deceive you. Decide what's good. You decide alone. But no one is alone.
I wish.
I know.
Wait until my mother hears I've slain the giant.
Jack, your mother is dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
She was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you, and she was struck a deadly blow by the prince's steward.
Why would he do that?
He was afraid that she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No one.
That steward will pay for this. After we slay the giant, I will slay him.
He'll do nothing of the kind.
He shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
No, I guess not.
Then he must die.
No.
Why not?
That would be wrong.
What he did was wrong, and he should be punished.
He will be somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm going to kill him.
Then kill him. No. No, no, don't kill him.
Mother isn't here now.
Wrong things, right things.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's true?
Nothing's quite so clear now.
Do things, fight things.
Feel you've lost your way.
You decide, but you are not alone.
Believe me, no one is alone.
No one is alone. Believe me.
Truly.
You move just a finger.
Say the slightest word.
Something's bound to linger.
Be heard.
No one acts alone. Careful. No one is alone.
People make mistakes.
Fathers.
People make mistakes,
holding to their own,
thinking they're alone. Honor their mistakes,
fight for the mistakes
everybody makes.
One another's terrible mistakes.
Witches can be right,
giants
can be good.
You decide what's right,
you decide what's good. Just remember.
Someone is on your side.
Our side.
Someone else
is not.
While we're seeing our side,
our side.
Maybe we forgot. They are not alone. No one is alone.
To see the light now.
Just don't let it go.
Things will come out right now. We can make it so.
Someone is on your.
Oh, here she comes.
All right, all right. And remember, don't let her know our plan. Stay with me.
Where is the boy?
We don't know.
Yes, we do. We can't go on hiding him any longer. He must pay the price for his wrongs.
Oh, quick, tell me where he is.
Over there.
See that tree? Where the birds are clustered. Jack is in that tree hiding.
Oh, thank you. Now justice will be served, and I shall leave your kingdom.
Every knot was one straight rope.
The harder to wake, the better to have.
The greater the good, the harder the blow.
When going to hide, know how to get there.
And how to get back.
And eat first.
The knife that is sharp today may be dull by tomorrow.
Now we can all return home. And let us hope there will be no more killing.
Where am I to go? I have no one to take care of me.
You'll have to take care of yourself now, Jack. It's time.
No, it's not. I'll take care of him.
You will?
Yes. I'll be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend. And a pet.
Of course, we have nowhere to go, so we'll move in with you.
Oh, no.
Oh, it'll be fun.
No, goodness, no. My house is a shambles. There is hardly room. Yes. Yes, of course you can come home with us.
And you shall join us, too.
You'll not return to the castle.
I'll gladly help you with your house. Well, there are times I do actually enjoy cleaning.
How proud my wife would have been of all of us. And how sad it is that my son will never know her. Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
And how will I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Yes, calm the child.
Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother. You'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the war. Do not let it grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone. No one is alone. Hold him to the light now. Let him see the glow. Things will be all right now. Tell him what you know.
Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, there lived...
Careful the things you say.
A young maiden.
Children will listen.
A sad young lad.
Careful the things you do.
A childless baker with his wife.
Guide them along the way. Children will glisten. Children will look to you for which way to turn, to learn what to be. Careful before you say, listen to me. Children will listen.
Careful the wish you make. Wishes are children. Careful the path they take. Wishes come true. Not free. Careful the spell you cast. Not just on children.
Sometimes the spell may last past what you can see and turn against you.
Careful the tale you tell, that is the spell. Children will listen.
Though it's fearful, though it's deep, though it's dark, and then you may lose the path you make out of wolves. You can't just be axed. You have to lose. So deep you can't just be. You have to fail. No telling when, be ready for the journey. Into the woods, but not too fast, or what you wish you lose at last.
Into the woods, but mind the past.
Into the woods, but mind the future.
Into the woods, but not to stray or
tempt the wolf or steal the giant. The way is dark, the light is dim, but now there's you, me, her, and him.
The chances look small,
the choices look grim.
By everything you learn, there will help when you return there.
The light is getting dimmer, I think I see a glimmer.
Careful,
Into the woods you have to go, but that's the way you learn to cope. Into the woods to find there's hope of getting through the journey. Into the woods each time you go, there's more to learn of what you know. Into the woods, but not too slow. Into the woods is hearing midnight. Into the woods to mind a wolf, to heed the witch, to honor the joy, to mind, to heed, to find, to think, to teach, to join, to go to the festival. Into the woods. Into the woods.